Hey, what is up, guys? Today's video, I'm gonna show you the most, or like one of the most broken cards in Clash Royale, in my opinion, which is under the radar for most of the players, and it's all about the Giant Skeleton. I decided to pick this deck because this deck is so strong. I saw a lot of players getting 12 wins with it and pushing high up in ladder. It's a Giant Skeleton Balloon Cycle deck with the Fisherman. The Fisherman Hunter Giant Skeleton combination is so broken. I use this deck a lot in CL, and I think it makes so much fun to play. And Giant Skeleton, I think everybody from us hates to play against in 2v2 especially. It's so strong competitive, but the 1v1 I think it's kind of underrated. You see the Giant Skeleton RG deck, or you see Giant Skeleton Balloon. If they're gonna build up a big goal and push just Giant Skeleton into that, play a Fishman to activate King Tower, play Skulls and Bells to pull the cards into the Giant Skeleton Bomb, and this is just insane. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to use creator code Modern Shop, really appreciate it. Helps me out a lot. Thank you so much for doing that. I would say, let's jump into some games. Come on, guys. We are doing it. So, guys, in the first game, we face Adrian Pedra. Good luck to Adrian, my friend. So, let's see what Adrian is playing. So, we're going for Miner as a start. We're not dropping on the safe spot because he is not going to play Tornado. We know it. We're feeling it. And we play against Lockbait. Lockbait isn't an easy matchup. So, we go just with a Balloon this time to kind of try to kill his Princess. He's using a Tesla against it. So, we're going to use Bats. We're going to use this. And then we're just going to Snowball this and hope we don't take any damage. Okay, that's fine. We go Fisherman over here. Oh, it's Mirror? Wow. What's happening here? Okay. We don't have anything in Scorpion Barrel besides Snowball, and here's Mirror Barrel. So I'm really interested to see how are we gonna win this? How are we gonna stop his cards? So does he have Rocket is the question. So we are going to Giant Skeleton for sure in the back right now. Going to try to build up a big push. This is going to be nasty. This is going to be interesting. So maybe we can build up a Balloon push, but I don't really know his deck. I don't really know his cards. This is not nice. So we go for a Miner like this. Okay. So I think Skeletons, Hunter, great defense. Fisherman like this. Okay, we are fine like this. So we go for Balloon here. I think he kind of overcommitted here. He still needs to go for Tesla anyway. Tesla plus Princess is not a worse trade. And I think the Prince is gonna die. And if the Prince is gonna die, it's a positive Elixir trade. Come on, Princess, die. Let's go, okay. He got so much damage because of the surprise factor. But let's see. Okay, Giant Skelly in the back. Hunter ready for his Goblin Barrel. It's gonna go in front, so we're just gonna use a Snowball over here and Skeletons. I don't really know if he has Rocket. This is the problem. I think he has Rocket. So at least that was a great play, but if he says Rocket, he's gonna go in with a Rocket. Maybe he doesn't. Did we get a Balloon shot on the right side? I don't really know. Miner. Bats. How is he gonna defend this? Can we go in? Oh my! Come on, Balloon! Come on! Let's go! We need to be careful now. Fisherman. Hunter. Looks like he just has... Okay, doing enough this. Man, I love Adrian. Adrian's a nice guy. So go for bats like this. And I think this is it. We're just gonna snowball his spear goblins. I don't really think he has a chance to defend this. GG's. GG's. Well played. Nice game against Adrian Pedra, one of the best players in the world. One of the best, like, I think all-time players. He was in CGS World Finals already. GG's, well played. Gonna see you in the next game. So, guess your next game against K4. Good luck to K4. I am really interested to see what is he coming up with. He's just gonna split bats. What is he gonna answer against? We're just gonna support one bat, like the two bats with my... Oh, he's playing the Mother Witch. Interesting to see the Mother Witch. So we're getting a King to activation, helps a lot honestly. because doesn't really matter which deck he's playing. If even if he's playing E-Golem, I don't really think he's playing Royal Giant, so King Calculation helps against like the Wahogis. I don't really see the Mana Witch a lot of times. In top lane, I think I played once against her out of like 10,000 games. I think Mana Witch is a bad card. What's your opinion about Mana Witch? You think she deserves a buff? Maybe like splash damage, but maybe she would be too broken. It's like really tough to say. So I think we're supporting this Giant Skeleton with Balloon. And even if he's gonna play troops into the Giant Skeleton, the nice thing is they're all gonna die. So King Tower is activated. He didn't really think about this. And if we're gonna snowball this, do we get another hit? That would be insane, guys, man. Balloon. I don't really like this card, but look at this. The Balloon Death Bomb. So I could argue about that. Maybe nerf Balloon a bit. You shouldn't be able to get the like so much death damage. Like you get the death, you get the bomb from the balloon, you're like, oh my goodness, this is insane. And then you get the death bomb and you kill the, like every troop from him. It's so insane. Look at this. Zappy's died because of a balloon. And balloon is not supposed to kill troops, it's just supposed to kill towers. So we're lucky for Mars. I don't think he has any chance to come back this game. So looks like she has just Flying Machine. Maybe it's like still Royal Hawks, but we're just gonna bats here. Does he have anything against the bats? It's not looking like it. He has to fireball the bats. You don't really want to do this. So we're just gonna knock it into the bomb. Just to make sure not get any damage. It's fine. We're just gonna be able to chip him out with a miner. Miner skeletons. You pressure him, he doesn't have Barbarian Barrel and Cycle, so it's a good play to do. I think we're just gonna slow roll here with a Giant Skeleton. Man, the Zappies died from skeletons. I can't believe it, guys. Going with bats high. Great bats. Okay, this is a bit unlucky. Annoying, I would say. Not really unlucky because it has nothing to do with luck. The problem is right now we have... Man, there are like 10,000 Hoggies. What's happening? 10,000 Hoggies. Can they maybe die? What's happening here? 10,000 Hoggies are coming. How broke is Mother Witch? Nerf Mother Witch, guys. Nerf Mother Witch. He needs to fireball this. Oh my goodness, I threw this game. I should have went all in for the tower trade. How bad I am. I'm so bad. And look at this, guys. 11, I am free. I mean, I wanted to do a video about the Giant Skeleton, but maybe the Mana Witch is the most broken card in Clash Royale. I had nothing in tank. Like, I had nothing in hand besides bats and Hunter, and I wasn't able to clean up, but this deck is insane, guys. Maybe we get the Mana Witch off this chest. That would be so nice, okay? Electric Giant Elise, we do 2 more games, come on, this deck is insane. I need to prove you that, I just need to improve my gameplay. So guys, next game against Masquigoyo? I don't really know, man, I'm still so sad about the last game, but it's fine. It's funny to show, I think, because I was so cocky, like, oh, this is an easy win, he can't do anything, and then I'm losing the game. So this shows you guys, you should always be focused. So he's gonna NATO this, I don't really know why, maybe at a bad cycle, but then we're just gonna punch him with Balloon here. E4, I don't have Nade on side, so it looks like a Golem deck. And you guys will see why Golem is a good matchup. You guys will see that. You guys will see that. So we're going for Hunter over here. Directly on the Baby Dragon. We have the Hunter, we have the Baby Dragon. We don't have a big spell, but that's the reason we have the good old boy, the Giant Skeleton in our deck. So we go for Miner, we go Skeletons. Yes, we go for Miner Skeletons. Why do we go with Miner Skeletons at this point? He doesn't have Barbarian Bell and... Okay, he has it back because of the Golem, but even still, we get a ton of chip damage. So we decide to go with Giant Skeleton to the right, and let's see, how is he gonna be supposed to break through? We can tank with the Giant Skeleton, we can Fissure his Golem, and then we go for Hunter directly on a supportive troop. So, this is the goal, and we will do it. So we go Fisherman over here. Is he gonna NATO this? He could. No, he's not, and now we're just gonna defend this, and there's like no way he's coming back from this game. So, bats are gonna die from a Giant Skeleton Bomb. We're up by 10,000 elixir. This is it! This is it! If you're strong against Golem, you wanna find a good counter against Golem. This is the deck you wanna play. Counter Golem with this Giant Skeleton Balloon Cycle deck. So, we're going in here aggressive, going for Miner in the back, because he has Tornado it anyway. And he has Tornado. Is he gonna NATO to the King? I wouldn't have done it. He's so low on elixir. Oh, the Tornadoes! Snowball, and please give me 2 hits. Please, I say please. Oh my goodness. GG's, well played. This would have said normally, but I remember the last game, so maybe it's not GG yet, we should focus up. Great skeleton placement, by the way. And yeah, I think we're just gonna go in for another balloon here, because it's Isuris, Nado, and Burying out of Saga, so there's no way for him to defend this. We get another tower, he's like, oh, I need to play a Night Witch. No, you can't, this is it, GG's. So, if we're losing this game now, I'm gonna donate all of you watcher, all of you viewers, 1k. So, be ready for that. So, let's see. He's gonna lightning this. We're gonna fisherman this. And we're just gonna hunter lightnings off cycle. We have a really cheap cycle as well. So even if he's gonna hunter, he's gonna kill one hunter with a lightning. Oh, the snowball! Like the snowball giant scan bomb combination is so great. Let's go, GG's. Man, that would have been 3 out of 3, but I decided to lose the first game. Why? I decided to lose the first game. I can't really tell you guys. But the balloon is connecting. Oh, GG's. 2 hours at least. And I would say we do one more game. Come on, guys. I'm gonna prove you this deck is insane. If you played white, it's insane. Okay, bro. If you played white, it's insane. Let's go. So, guys, your next game against you, Mad Bro. Okay. Good luck to him. He's aggressive, sir. He's aggressive. And the nice thing about this deck is also like not everybody's expecting this deck. So if they're seeing like the giant skeleton, they're always like, is this a random deck? And then you're like, no. This is a typical meta deck, and it got played in CL quite a lot. So, different set variations sometimes, but honestly, you start really aggressive. You don't really want to do that. So, it looks like a Pekka deck, and Pekka's a good matchup. You guys will see why. We have the Hunter, we have a cheap cycle. Giant Scan is good against Pekka too. So, let's see. Is he gonna drop a Pekka here? Yes, he does, but we will do this. You're like pushing in the same Nade Morton. That's a bad move. No, it's not. Because if he's gonna play an Ewis, the Ewis is immediately gonna die in a Giant Scan. But why does he have Archers? I mean, this is tower down. And the nice thing about Balloon also is Balloon creates a ton of 100-0 matchups in your favor. So, for sure, in some matchups you have to struggle if you play against Building plus Tornado. But honestly, sometimes your opponent can't really do anything if you know that. So, an example, you play against some Hawk Rider decks, you play against some decks which don't really have an air counter, or like have a bad starting hand, and they just have like bats against air, so they're just, you're just able to like, Balloon gets a 1-0 match, and they can't do anything, you don't even need to play well, and this is like, Balloon is one of these cards, kinda. I think that's not really a typical card, maybe like Lavaloon is another deck, if you have like, bad cards against, you can't do anything, but yeah, honestly, this deck is great against Minor Worldbreaker also, so if you struggle against Minor Worldbreaker, this is the deck you want to play. So go for Hunter Low. This is your G, by the way. Like the second game, you know, guys. So great defense over here. He could zap this, but this is over. Come on, we're just going to finish him. Can we freak on him? Let's see. Is he going to give up already? He's playing a really interesting Bridgeman variation. I wouldn't have recommended that because EU's rich version is way more solid than this. But yeah, let's see. Can we go in here with a... I don't know. Hey, man, I just want to win a game. I don't like this. I don't really like to play against this. I would say we're just going to skip this game. And we do one more game. Come on, this game is not funny. I think you guys saw how you play against... even if we would have played an Ewers on the left side, it would have been fine. So I'm going to see you in the next game. Let's go. We're going to cut the rest out. So guys, see you in the next game. This is the last game for today's video. Hope he's a better player than the last one. No personal attack against him. So we go with bats in the back. And we go in with a giant skeleton. How is he gonna answer this? So... he's dropping a giant. So it looks like it's gonna be the balloon deck. I would love to have Fisher and Cycle, but I don't. So we're just going minor here. In case he's gonna try to Fisher that, so our death bomb is for sure killing his death bomb. At the same time, we're chipping away on the Zappies, so if I would have had Fisher, it would have been insane. We could pull the giant skeleton away. But it's fine. He decides to hunter this, we're just gonna Fisher into the hunter. So, giant skeleton RG. Okay. We're deciding to drop this, like, kinda supporting our boy. And we are gonna hunt this. Oh my, let's go, guys. The hunter didn't get a shot. Now we're just gonna spam. We are up by Elixir. And if you know what happens if you're up by Elixir, he doesn't just have Earthquake. And with Earthquake, he doesn't have a big spell. And so I don't really know how he's gonna defend this. Okay, yes. The Giant Skeleton. But Giant Skeleton is kinda dead. So it gives us like a big, positive, huge positive Elixir. He has Zappies and Hunter against Air. He has Skelly. So most likely he doesn't have E-Spirit. Normally I play E-Spirit in the deck. Okay. What is this guy playing? Why is he so aggressive? Skeleton in the pocket, in the pocket in the middle. Kinda like distracting the giant skeleton, let's go. And we are fine. And skeleton in the back. Maybe should do it. I think it's the best play right now. Using a hunter or using a fisherman is not good because we need to have these cards in hand in case he's gonna go from the wild giant in the bridge. So it's fine. Giant skeleton, okay, he is gonna go in. I think we're going in right now, aggressive on the opposite side. Because you guys will see right now what I meant with that. Look at it! Oh my, this giant skeleton! This is insane. Look at the bats! Look at the bats, guys! I meant he didn't have anything in sight against it, right? So we're going in. Oh my, we are playing him right now. He is going with a hunter. We're predicting it! But now we're just gonna snowball back. This is it! There's no way he's gonna defense. We could just gonna go for low fisherman in case he wants to predict with a high fisherman. He's gonna EQ defensive. This is it. GG's, well played in this matchup. Baiting out the hunter. He needs to play the hunter at some point, like to kind of support this royal giant because he doesn't have anything against bats. He doesn't even have electric spirit. And this time we're going in opposite side and we get the huge positive elixir trade. OJ would be so happy with that. With the fisherman against the Royal Giant. So GG's, well played. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna see you in tomorrow's one. Have a great day. Peace out. Leave a like, leave a subscribe.